Oh, yes, and we got him.
Oh, I've got one. I'm in. Hey, that's really excellent.
Oh, he's a big one.
Fantastic fish. Absolutely beautiful. We must put her back.
Wonderful new dimension to fly fishing. We're fishing of any kind of fish, but some of the really gives you a battle on this tackle. That's what I love.
And off he goes.
I spent many happy hours as a kid on this river learning to catch wild, nervous brown trout on the fly. A half pounder was a good fish and a pounder was a giant, but even then I always dreamed of catching a really big trout on the fly. Here in England, the average size of trout caught is much bigger than in Ireland. Yet, they have fewer lakes and rivers and many more anglers. The reason for this is that the English give nature a little helping hand.
Did you get a fish?
Yeah, it's a nice one.
Oh, lovely. Can I?
Yeah, certainly.
He's a clean fish, isn't he?
Yeah.
In order to meet angling demand, this has evolved. The put-and-take trout fishery. Quite literally, these fish are grown on in captivity, and when they're big enough, you put them in the lake, and the angler comes along and takes them out, hence the phrase. And it works very well, even on small lakes like this one. The fishery managers get to make a living, and the angler can catch good-sized trout all year round. And he is a good-sized trout. Thank you.
As demand for trout fishing soared, people started making artificial lakes which were easy to access and manage. This introduced a new element, competition. Fishery owners soon realised that bigger fish meant more anglers, and so the fish just kept getting bigger and bigger. And the biggest fish of all can be found here at Sutton Springs Trout Fishery in Hampshire.
It's amazing, you know, when a fish turns in the pool in front of you, and he's probably at least 10 pounds. Virtually every fish that I can see moving in this pool is between 10 and 25 pounds in weight. And it's a very small pool. We've got a beautiful chalk stream running along the back here, and there are fish in there too. I think I've seen them to about 5-6 pounds, and they are unbelievable fish by river standards, but 25, 28, 30 pounds in this pond. Well, I'm going to fish here first.
Nigel Jackson designed and built this fishery, which only a few years ago was nothing more than a field. For most of his life, he has been perfecting the art of growing a tiny egg into a monster trout in just 3 or 4 years. His fish are reared in specially constructed ponds, and when they're big enough, he transports them to his lake to be released. Anglers need only to turn up to enjoy a big trout fishing bonanza.
You know what occurred to me? That all the big fish in this pond have spent their whole lives eating these pellets. Fish of 10 or 12 pounds really should be feeding on other fish. So what I'm going to do is tie on one of these. It's a pike fly and it imitates a fish, and it might be interesting to see what happens.
I was curious to see if they had lost any of their natural predatory instincts, so I got special permission from Nigel to carry out my little experiment.
And we're in. Oh! Well, it's our first fish. And he's not too big. He's probably only about 10 pounds. But they do fight very well. I'm not here too long. And this is probably the biggest trout I've ever had on in my life. It just goes to show these fish haven't lost any of their predatory instincts. It's a beautiful fish, absolutely beautiful fish. That's a 5-inch fish imitation. And almost straight away, it's produced a fish like that.
Whoa! Look at that.
That's probably the biggest trout I will ever see in my life. Unless I catch another one out of here. Oops! Oh! 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 Well, there he goes. We'll afford to let that one go. Let's get another one.
With my curiosity satisfied, I switch back to conventional tactics to enjoy catching double-figure trout on tiny nymphs.
Oh, he's a big one. They're all big ones.
Oh, look at that. That is impossibly big. Unbelievable.
Now this may be a small pool, and the fish aren't all that difficult to catch, but I promise you, if you get one this size on the end of your line, there'll be a big grin at the other end. Fantastic.
Back on my favourite trout river, I couldn't help feeling that catching all those big trout somehow seemed just a bit too easy. Although I enjoyed catching those monster trout, I really missed the thrill of the chase.
I've been watching that trout now for about 5 minutes, and even though he's only about a tenth the size of those big rainbows back in England, a wild Irish brownie like that presents a far more challenging quarry. There's been no rain here for about 2 weeks and the water's quite clear, so I'll probably only get about 2 casts at him. The trout always face upstream into the current and they wait for the food to come back down to them. And I've got to get this little artificial fly to land on the surface, just above the trout. And when it comes down over his head, he looks up and sees it and he thinks it's a real fly. And hopefully he'll come up and take it. It's a lot easier said than done.
I've got to be careful here because the fish is in the flat water and there's a lot of faster water between me and the fish. And I only have a couple of seconds for the fly to come over his head before it starts to drag. And then no self-respecting trout would ever take it. This is clearly an artificial. these fish are extremely nervous. Slightest hint of danger and they just streak off, and you don't see them again for an hour, I'd say, or more. Oh yes, and I got him. Well, I cover. He's a very small fish, and they are very difficult when the water is this clear. But was it worth the effort? Well, yes, you have to say it was. There he is. Super. Look at that for an absolutely beautiful. Wild as a March hare. They say size isn't everything, and in this case, I have to agree. I really enjoyed catching those big rainbows in England, but fooling a little guy like this on the fly is far, far more fun. It's not often a tiddler is preferred to a whopper. And that's fishing.